Some folks like to sigh. Some folks do, some folks do. Some folks never try. But that's not me nor you. Long live the merry, merry heart that sings by night and day, like a queen of mirth, no matter what some folks say. Some folks fret and scold, some folks do, some folks do. They'll soon be grey and old. But that's not me nor you. Long live the merry, merry heart that sings by night and day, like a queen of earth, no matter what some folks say.
Increasing his wealth.
But his neighbor's life was hard and wretched.
For misery. Lived in his house. Thank you. was always cold. Chimney corner. Worst of all, oh misery, slept in the poor man's bed.
They turned their backs upon one another and shivered under the blankets. Flowers coming into bloom. Very bad. If only misery
did not live with us.
So, she spoke kindly to her husband and asked him if they could find some way to drive misery out.
The husband was touched by her words and began to think. Then he went into his woodshed and picked up a wide plank of wood,
which he'd been storing for some time, just in case it might one day turn out to be of some use. He called to his wife. And together they set out into the wild wood. After they had walked some way,
the man looked back.
And saw misery following them. They came to a deep stream.
And the husband put down the plank.
For his wife. To walk. Across.
Quickly, he followed her.
Pulling up the plank before misery could reach it.
But when he glanced back again,
he saw that misery had moved a huge tree trunk. And was still following behind.
Now, the poor man knew of an old hollow tree deep in the woods. When he reached it, he cut off a branch from the tree and began to shape some wooden wedges.
living with misery any longer.
He said loudly to his wife,
I am going to shut myself up in this hollow tree so that he can never get at me again. You must help drive in the wedge's wife to hold the plank fast and keep him out.
I will do it, husband,
said the wife, for she could see that her husband was setting a trap. Misery could not bear to see the poor man escaping. So at the last moment, just as the man was climbing in, Misery jumped into the hollow tree. And at once, the poor man jumped out again. And with his wife's help, put the plank in place. And drove the wedges home. When it was done,
the poor man
and his wife looked at one another. Soon, the poor man's house was a very different place. The fire burned brightly. And the food tasted good. And with Misery gone from their bed, the poor man and his wife kept one another warm and slept well at night. Vegetables in the garden flourished. to bring to market. And soon
they had enough money to buy a pig.
The wife sang as she swept and kept the house clean.
Some folk say,
with misery gone, life was worth living
at last.
Like the Queen of Love, no matter what some folk say. The poor man was still afraid that misery might escape the hollow tree and come back to plain. So he went to the tree each week to make sure that all the wooden wedges were still tight. And if any were loose, he would hammer them back in again.
Thank you.
Man home.
Thank you.